I would just hate to be the one who ends up convincing my great-grandfather of your noble deeds just to find out that you raised an army to finish what was started.
He looks at him, says, I can only even give you my word that it will not happen. I am unsure how else I could convince you.
How about this instead, then? I give my word.
Your word does. All of your words mean something to me. But let me give you a challenge. This is no time for games, indeed, but it is time for challenges. I want you to go to the rock, to see what it signals. It's a marker, really, to let you find the place. And I want you to find that those wilders that came with you. And I want you to take them with you. They will not like it. And I think, regarding your scroll, I think I know, for a reasonable fact, that I know where the distortion coming from, and that that black fella is in fact related to its source. He winks. I want you to at least try to convince those two of what you might find.
Well,
I'd say we can certainly try.
American shrugs. We can try.
There are many dark things afoot, but, well, you'll see. Too many.
Circus or something.
Welcome! Do, 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 do.
We have to stay here for 6 months.
Oh, no!
Can't stay, but have fun.
Fun is mandatory.
Anyway, yeah, I mean, we can bring him with us. Grammar's not threatened by them.
No, we can bring them with us, fine. We'll try to be nice.
Cordial, even?
Mm-hmm. Might even smile.
You will find the impact location rather easily. It is just some distance from here, and he'll basically explain to you how you get there. By walking that way and following that and that star, as it were. Things like that. So he says, and now consider you formally and aggressively kicked out of my forest.
How do we
get those with us?
I suspect that they will find you eventually. And if they don't arrive before you get there, then, well, drugs. I'll try to get them there. Let's put it that way.
All right.
And then I think
we can
converse.
Let's begin following the instructions.
Yep. Yes. Conversation.
All right. The copper, the wilderhead, as it were, does nod as a sort of goodbye. Before heading back into the bushes.
The copperhead.
The copperhead, yeah. Where he quickly talks to his two escorts, still sort of lingering in the back and being thoroughly confused about what's happening. And eventually he does turn around and give you the gesture basically to just get out of here.
Mm-hmm.
Before people decide things.
Alright, we get out of here.
Following the direction he gave you does take quite a while, a few days of travel, even with travel made slightly faster with both Warwick and Hirondo presumably flying, occasionally carrying you around. It's not too difficult with those four of you. And while you do occasionally, in fact, not exactly get ambushed, but certainly meet, another term, it does seem like the word of letting you or leaving you alone has spread. You get the occasional challenge, which is more a proof to maybe some other turn watching somewhere that they are particularly brave. But no actual threatening combat happens, unless you wanted to, of course.
No.
Maybe we'll even spare them, like just knocking them on their back. And, you know, proving our strength and then leaving them.
It would be a bit of a standoff, you know, Herondor spreading his wings, roaring, stuff like that.
Stomping the ground.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Whatever Wildlers do to show themselves being awesome.
Shortly before you think you'll probably arrive where you've been sent, you do notice during one of your flights that it does seem like you're being followed from a distance of two shapes, presumably trying to catch up with you, or at least trying to stay in sight range. They don't seem to be rushing particularly fast. And you also eventually, cresting over hills, see your presumed goal, your presumed destination. A reasonably sized crater, which isn't too deep, basically just a patch of burned and scorched grass with a bit of a rock in the middle. Landing, going there, the rock itself seems utterly, well, rocky. But not much else. It is about as magical as the rest of the place, and really doesn't seem to have any use whatsoever. Enric and Natalia and everyone who investigates can agree on that. However, touching the crater is the entrance to a cave. A tunnel, as it were, leading almost vertically down. A hole, almost. There are signs that something, a term presumably has entered here before, but it does not seem to be a commonly used tunnel to anywhere or by anyone. It certainly does not look like a lair of any kind to either Warwick or Hirondor. And going down, you quickly realize that it goes deep. The tunnel, first being sort of a tunnel inside dirt, quickly turns into a tunnel inside rock. The rock, seemingly natural, although slightly almost melted in places. Eventually, winding down into the earth leads you to a strange and, more importantly enough, somewhat familiar sight, as eventually the long, winding, rocky tunnel that is just barely enough for Hirondor and Warwick to fit through opens up into pretty much nothing. It's just a black void that you can see. Occasionally flits of, or wisps of light, of colored light, whizzing about. And you do stand in front of a structure floating inside that void. A wooden drawbridge connecting the stone structure with the tunnel that you currently stand in, with the void just all around. A stone structure that you recognize as having been in before, as having met strange creatures before, as having met Erasmus in before. It is the same sort of odd stone structure floating in the void, although far less destroyed than last time you've been there. The hallways in good, pristine condition, really, glowing with odd lights that seem to form sentences, even pictures, that none of you can really understand. From behind you, you do hear the clawing and scraping of Tenem trying to traverse this tunnel. And as they pretty much peek around the corner, perhaps hoping to just simply observe what you're doing, but being noticed by you, I think we'll stop for this week, as the next part is going to take a little while.
Dun, dun, dun.
I hope my description has been vivid enough, as I do not have a nice map to present to you, but that is something I can prepare for next time.
Hooray, next time.
Now we get sheet maps. Yeah, 4K.
I sort of tend to draw the line when it comes to preparation after 6 hours. So if preparation takes me longer, I don't usually make nice maps. But since I don't have much to prepare for next time, I can actually spend a lot of time on that.
6 hours is a lot of prep time.
Yeah.
One setting at least.
That's as long as the game. That's longer than the session.
Exactly.
I guess my prep time would be high too, but that's more like in 10-minute increments whenever I think about it. You know?
I have really long prep times in the beginning where I do all the maps, basically, or like I just do a huge pile of them usually.
I can't do that though. I literally can't.
Yeah. My prep time is very sporadic, where it's, I'll have a week where I've got like an hour's prep time, a week where I've got half an hour, then a week where I've got like a ton, and then it goes back down again, then back up, then back down. I prepare everything in blocks. Here's block A, here's block B, here's block C.
There's chapter one done. Get better, like, first idea is usually trash, and then sort of they get more refined.
My game development teacher actually told me basically whenever I was doing projects with him, which was whatever the first idea you come up with is, scrap it, and then go on and create a new one.
That sounds stupid.
Because the second one will probably always be better than the first.
Well, it's more like refinement for me, at least.
Rework it, basically.
You can take an incremental advance. I think you've done enough.
Yeah.
Got a double strength battle in this fight, in this session even.
What does that mean?
Incremental.
It's basically
two.
Yeah, it's basically as strong as two battles combined.
Anyone want next relationship die?
What?
I guess that is the next thing we can get, but no,
yes.
I'm good.
No, I'm fine as well, thank you.
You feel like you need more relationship die?
No.
You do.
I really don't.
Yes, you do.
Hit points? Or spell upgrade?
No, that's the question. Probably
you'd want spell upgrade,
point.
Right? Because you can get like it's awesome super level spells.
I mean, I'm at level 7 spells, yes.
Oh, that's true. So,
it might...
so it's not an upgrade for me, honestly. I would probably take HP, maybe, because I'm certainly...
You're squishy.
...struggling in that regard.
Yeah, I'm certainly taking spell upgrade, because that means my Javelin of Faith will now be the level 7 version.
Mm-hmm.
Which, of course, my main DPS spell. So...
True.
7th level Wave of Decay.
I could take an epic tier feat, though.
You could take an epic tier
feat. I did that first. That's very good.
Yes, my damage is changing from 66 to 6010. Which is... it's okay. I'm looking at the epic feat for Javelin of Faith and wondering if I want it later, though. Which is, if you roll a natural 18+, plus, you get to make the attack again against a different target, the free action.
Mm-hmm. Well, interesting.
I will fire all the javelins of faith. I will keep rolling 18 plus sheep. Just constantly 18 plus.
I'll upgrade the wraith, summon wraith spell.
Terrifying.
They get two wraiths.
Oh, really? That might actually be worth it now that I think of it.
Fairly good. Get that level 7. And then after that, just two greater wraiths at level 9. You know, just put more wraiths in there. Wraiths are nice.
They are.
They can fly and have resistance and stuff.
They have like an
ice sword. I mean, they're pretty squishy, all things considered.
Well, they have damage resistance. I mean, that's decent, I think.
No. I have a decent to hit against PD, that's mostly. Like about them.
Yeah. Hitting MD, that's where it's at.
The Wave of Decay for 3d12 per escalation die is also pretty nice.
Mm-hmm. You think I just realized I can pick up technically now?
Is
if I feel like it, I can pick up Resurrection.
Yay, Ooh. Resurrection.
Should you need it? You guys like 3 times in your life.
It's true, but I have resurrection as an option I can now take. It's a 7th level spell. I can do it.
Summon horror just isn't that good. Like a barrow white.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah. Yeah. It's like one shot by everything.
Yeah, it's pretty sucky.
52 hit points nowadays is nothing compared to what we fight. Like, the Mook has more hit points than this thing.
Yep.
And it doesn't have that sweet thing that the ghoul has by making things. The good thing about that is that it can make things vulnerable to us.
That wasn't Resurrection Larian, that was reincarnation, but yes.
I don't think reincarnation is a thing in
Planet Age. When Herondor dies, we can, you know, he'll be reincarnated as a goblin.
And then he'd kill himself.
Aw, we'll reincarnate him again.
I cannot.
I do like the idea, though, of forging all Tenonym aspects onto Herondor and make him Mr. Tiamat, basically.
Just some lore background here. It is possible for Tenonym to have multiple essences. Two is uncommon, but not entirely unusual. Jax, for example, would be an example. Although already having just two different sort of sets of instincts has the tendency to drive Tenonym near mad. There have been some who have actively tried to embody all the essences to get closer to being like the Radio of Rainbow Scales, but that has always ended in absolute insanity.
Well, someone has to be the first, and with the power of the scythe to help him, and likely also some appropriate souls from powerful Tavernier each color,
yeah.
maybe some of their essence could be used by him, like just deposited in his body for him to use.
It would be like a Demolicious jewels, yeah. Basically.
Yeah, exactly. Fastened upon his body. The soul gems, and then he can utilize their essence too.
Exactly.
Power his own abilities.
Exactly.
Each scale on his body from a different Tenonym.
Mm-hmm.
Each a different color, and each holding the essence of that Tenonym for him to use.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Just imagine it.
This power can be yours, Halldamir. You only need to say the word.
Nope.
It's the word, I suppose.
Yep, that's the word. Talia, prepare the ritual.
No! Stop it in 3 seconds.
Well, Graham. Keep him occupied. I need 1d3 plus 1 round. Someone
there we go.
I can probably keep him occupied in 3 seconds.
Hold him down.
Well, 3 rounds, taking up 3 seconds.
Just summon all the zombies.
Yeah, yep, just 3 rounds. Him. Yeah, but I can fly over zombies.
And we grab you. That's the thing. Everyone grabs you.
It's between 12 and 24 seconds you need to keep him busy.
Grab him. Grab him.
Also, once again, thank you, Isakawa, for doing some art for us.
Yeah.
We like it a lot. Thank you.
All right.
Come at me, you big lizard. I love it.
I'm going to go to bed. I'm going to stop the stream. Thanks for watching.
Epic feat for summoning Wraith. When it's Escalation Die Plus 3, you get 3 Wraiths.
Oh, I'm going to get the epic tier for Smite Evil.
That do?
4d12 extra damage instead of.
I got the one for my strength thing as an increment event last time to get the d20s once per day. Whack those guys with my bonus damage. The dream is at some point that I'll get the triple crit and then be able to fire it.
One day.
I'll use my book at the same time to do so much damage.
One day.
There's not really any epic tier feats that are good for the maneuvers that I have.
I have a lot of standard feats right now, too. Just like improved initiative.
Yeah, it's really good.
Placeholder feats so far. Because a lot of them are like, eh. You know, like, Wave of Decay no longer ends when you hit your 0 hit points, but when you fail death save. Like, when does that ever happen?
Yeah, like, you're like, eh.
Like, such a rare case that it just doesn't matter.
I agree.
Yeah, no, there's, like, no epic tier feats for fighters that interest me.
Most of the good necromancer spells don't have any. Except for, like, you know, instead of a D3 plus 1, it's now D4 plus 1 mooks you summon. It's like, that's like, once every weak. 3 times you use it, you get one extra mook. You're not going to notice that.
No.
You want feats that you notice you have.
No. Like the...
this is a cool feat.
I, for one, am going to throw my food in the microwave.
Well, there we go.
Alright.
I suppose that's it then. Thank you everyone for watching, and we'll play some Shadowrun tomorrow. Right?
Theoretically?
Sure.
Theoretically. I don't remember exactly what we were doing, but I think I'm going to be basically in my room all session decoding the Diaz incident.
So you don't get the entire time with business?
What? Yeah. No!
Alright.
You're busy! Hang with me, finger to the...
busy! Your ear. No! Greg, no!
Well, I have no idea what Jonas just said. I think I, if that works, I'm going to stream some Crusader Kings before the session. Something like 4.
There we go.
Somewhere around there.
Look, really good into that game.
Like,
I have. It's so ridiculous. It's great.
Tune in good tomorrow night, afternoon then to find Sheep's Satan horse take over Europe. It's going to be great. And yeah. If not that, we'll see you in session. Good night.
Good night.